and that is a 29 ounce can of peaches, or you could use 2 15-ounce cans. Now we're gonna take a box of vanilla cake mix, and you're just gonna dump it right on top. Now you could use yellow cake mix if you want. I chose vanilla because I think it's gonna be the perfect flavor. Use your fingers to just flatten that out on the top there.
Wow.
There you go. This is the easiest cobbler you'll ever make. 3 ingredients, peaches, cake mix, and now we're just gonna cover this cake mix with the butter. And we've got our 3 ingredients, butter, cake mix, and peaches. Now we're gonna add some cinnamon sugar. We're just gonna sprinkle that over the top. This is just extra, just in case. And now I've actually got some brown sugar as well. And that is gonna make this nice and sweet. But what if you're watching your calories? Maybe you need less sugar or you're on a diet. You can make some easy swaps for this. In fact, they make these no sugar added peaches. That's an option that you could use. Use 2 cans of the 15 ounce. They also have a keto and gluten-free yellow cake mix. This would work too. So if you're gluten-free, try that. And this will make it a little bit of a lighter dessert for you. And you put the lid on it and wait. And your house is gonna smell divine. And you're filling right on the bottom. 1 can of crushed pineapple. It's been drained. You can see all the liquid is gone. Just dump that right on top. Perfect. Just kind of scoot that around. Now we're gonna add a box of white cake mix. You could use yellow, you could use sugar-free, keto, gluten-free, whatever cake mix you prefer works just fine for this. You're gonna dump the entire thing out. You do not want to mix it, because if you mix it, that will mess it up. Trust me on this. You don't want to mix it, but you can use your hands to just kind of flatten that out, press it down, just like that. There you go. And now I need some butter to go on top, please.
Butter?
Yep, all right, that's some butter in the fridge.
I can get that for you. All right. Butter is right here. All right, perfect.
Great. Now I've already cut this one up and pre-sliced it. We're gonna take these little slices and we're just gonna cover the top of our dry cake mix.
So you don't mix it at all. You just put the butter right on the top. Mm-hmm. And that kind of creates a crust, right?
Yeah, exactly. You've seen me do these before. These are called dump cakes. And if you haven't tried them in the crock pot, you need to, because the great thing about this is you can just set it and forget it. Dump it in, go shopping. The crock pot will do all the work for you.
Does it do any other kind of work? Like, does it clean the house or anything like that? It just cooks.
You and your jokes. Now, remember I said that I drained the pineapple juice from the crushed pineapple. We're not gonna waste that. We're gonna take that pineapple juice and we're gonna pour it right on top.
Oh, wow, okay.
Yep, and that's gonna mix with this cake mix as well. It's gonna be really good. There you go. And then we're gonna top that with some coconut flakes. Now these are optional. Let me know in the comments if you think that this is a good addition or if you would leave off the coconut. In fact, go ahead and tell me in the comments what you would do differently with this recipe. Is there something else that you would add? Did I go wrong? Let me know, because I do read your comments. And also tell me where you're from. I'm from Mississippi originally, but we live in Vegas now, and I love to hear from y'all. All right, I think we can go ahead and start this now. This one is high for 2 hours, or you could do low for 4 hours. And then you just put the lid on, 2 cans of pumpkin. This is the pure pumpkin puree. And then you're gonna take some evaporated milk. This is 1 can. Pour that right in top. You're gonna take 3 eggs. Lightly beaten, just a beaten a little bit, just enough to break the yolk. There you go. We're gonna take 1/4 cup of brown sugar. I'm using the organic brown sugar, but I really am curious of what your thoughts are. Is organic worth it, or is it a waste of money? Let me know in the comments, see what you think of that. Next, we're gonna add 1 cup of pure cane sugar, which is essentially just granulated sugar. There we go. Pour that in. Then we're gonna add 1 teaspoon of. Now we're gonna add 1 teaspoon of vanilla. There we go. And pumpkin pie spice, 2 teaspoons. There we go. Now we're gonna mix that up right inside of our crock pot.
This mixing way, it in the slow cooker.
Yep. This way, you're not dirtying extra dishes. You're just gonna mix that up right inside the pot. What we're making here today is a delicious pumpkin cobbler. Have you ever tried a I can't say pumpkin today. Pumpkin cobbler? Have you ever
tried? Just gonna keep that in?
Say that 5 times fast. Pumpkin cobbler. It's hard. Now that looks beautiful. This is basically like pumpkin pie filling now, what we've created here. And we're gonna top that with some butter pecan cake mix.
Super moist.
Right on top, butter guys. Pecan. Sprinkle it right on top. Do not mix it. If you mix it, you're not gonna get the desired result.
Really?
Trust me on this. Whole thing, and just flatten that out with your hands. That's totally fine.
This is so crazy.
There we go. Now I need something from the fridge.
Oh yeah.
I need some butter.
Butter? Okay. I can get butter out of the fridge. Here it is. 2 sticks.
Great. Now you gave me this cool little butter slicing tool.
Yes, this
is crazy. So we're
gonna
try that.
See, it's got little wires there.
Because what you need for this is some thin slices of butter, and they're gonna go right across the top.
All right.
And you just, I'll let you do it, okay? Use my hand.
Oh gosh, this is never
ready?
Work.
You think you can do it?
No way. You're gonna have to
do
it.
So it's gotta be me? Okay, yes, here we go, watch.
Just push it down.
You just push it down like that.
There you go.
Beautiful.
Perfect.
This is such an ingenious device. So now you take your butter slices and you cover the top of your cake mix. You really want to make sure you get as much of the dry cake mix covered with a slice of butter as possible. Now, you could melt this butter and then pour it over the top. That's an option.
That's no fun.
This is even easier in my opinion because it's just one less step. Because why do you need to melt it if it's gonna melt it when it's in the crock pot anyway, right?
Yes.
All right, got that covered totally. We're almost done. We're gonna top that with some pecans. These are optional, but of course, with our butter pecan mix, this is gonna be yummy. Just right over the top. And something magical is gonna happen inside of this crock pot to this cake mix and the butter. It's gonna melt into it, create this wonderful fluffy top layer. A little bit of brown sugar, just because. You're gonna get a cobbler layer, which ends up being nice and fluffy. And we're gonna bake this on low for 3 to 4 hours. You smell that?
It smells good.
Oh, I wish you guys had smell-o-vision. This 3-ingredient cobbler is ready. It looks delicious, but we're missing one more thing. I like a la mode.
Yes.
We gotta have some ice cream with this.
That's in the freezer.
There's some vanilla ice cream.
Vanilla ice cream in the freezer. All right, let me grab that. Ah, here it is.
Oh, I can't wait to dig in. Perfect. I actually picked the sugar-free kind to make this a little bit healthier. So we got our ice cream. We got our cobbler. We got our bowl. All right, let's dig in.
All right, wait, I actually don't like eating mine with a spoon. I'd rather have a fork.
You eat your ice cream with a fork.
It is weird, I know. Let me, hold on. I can fix this. Hold this just like that.
All right.
Watch this. This is going to be so cool. Watch. I'm just going to grab it like this. And yeah, hold on to it. Hold on to the fork.
I'm holding
it. And I'm just going to pull it like this. And I'm going to turn that into a fork like that.
Oh, okay, there's your fork.
All right, there you go.
All right, let's dig in.
Yes, here we go.
Check this out, guys. Look at how good this
looks. Whoa.
So you've got a beautiful cobbler topping from that cake mix. Look at that. This is gonna be so good. And we've got our peaches. Oh yeah, look at that. Oh, I can't wait to taste this. Hold that.
All right.
Big old scoop of vanilla ice cream. Boom. Does not get any better than this.
All
and
right.
There's your fork, since you can't eat ice cream with a spoon, apparently.
That's a weird thing.
He's not kidding. He actually really does eat his desserts with a fork. All right, moment of truth. Oh my gosh, this is so easy. You just throw everything in the crock pot, you forget about it. You have to try this, this is so good. Oh my gosh. Do you smell that?
It smells so good.
It looks fantastic. It's nice and fluffy. This is so delicious. I already know it. I can taste it. But we're missing a very important ingredient.
Pickles.
No, we do not need pickles. It's ice cream. You have to have some ice cream with this, right? Yes. Now, I'm on a diet, so I chose to use the Carb Smart No Sugar. So we're going to use that one for this one instead. Let's get a scoop of that.
Okay.
Go ahead and ready. Look at that. This is going to be perfect. All right. Got my scoop ready. Got my plate here. Will you hold that, please?
I'll hold the plate.
You ready, guys? Drum roll.
Drum roll, please.
Look at this.
Whoa. It actually looks good on the top right there.
It looks nice and fluffy.
Like a fluffy cake.
So we have some of the cherries already coming out, but that is totally fine. I think I'm going to go. And you see how it's kind of nice and brown on the side? This ended up being perfect. We're going to go right here.
All right, so this is kind of like...
So this is, and listen guys, if you're thinking that this is going to be like a cake, it doesn't necessarily have that kind of texture because this is almost like a cobbler, but this is nice and fluffy on top because we used that. Look at that. Wow, look how hot it is. Get some more of the good juice, cherries and pineapple. Wow. Okay, this is going to be
and
delicious.
And a little bit of ice cream right there. All right.
Ready?
Yep.
Ice cream on top. Sugar-free, of course. All right, I can't wait to try this. If you are a fan of quick and easy desserts.
I like quick and easy.
Mm. Wow.
Is it good?
Man, that cake is really good. It's nice and moist. I think the addition of the juice is what made it so nice and fluffy. So that was a good call. You guys are gonna love this one. Be sure to hit the follow button. We post new recipes every single day. And let me know in the comments what you want to see us cook next. I love hearing your requests. This is one of my favorites now.
Yeah, well, don't eat it all. Save some for me.
Okay, here you go. All right, y'all. Our pumpkin cobbler is ready. Now, it cooks in the crock pot and it gives you a nice fluffy cake topping. It definitely is not a crispy top cobbler. I know there's different versions of cobblers out there. If you want this to be crispy on top and flaky, you can bake this in a casserole dish in the oven at 350 degrees for 45 minutes. But in the crock pot, it really is nice and moist and it gives you a nice fluffy topping. And let's check it out. Okay, see what I mean?
Oh, I see.
All right, I'm gonna grab my bowl.
There you go.
We're gonna get a nice big scoop. See? All right. Oh yeah, this is gonna be good.
Look at that.
Ready?
Yep.
Here we go. Whoa. You see what I mean? About how it's kind of fluffy on top?
Yeah.
I'm gonna get a little bit more. See, the cake mix does fully cook. My fork. This is a different way to try pumpkin. If you're bored of boring old pumpkin pie, then this is a nice option for you instead. And this is a butter pecan topping, remember? So it gives you that nice pecan flavor too. Okay, here we go.
What do you think?
You're gonna like this one. Kyle loves pumpkin pie. I'm not done yet.
Well, give me a bite. Can I not?
Oh, no. That's what I get for being a pig. You're gonna like it.
Ha, 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 ha,
I told you.
Why would you just come in?
It's hot.
It's very good though.
It's really good.
But it's hot. Let it cool.
We both just burned our mouths. Y'all, this is delicious though. Cook this one, but just remember to let it cool first. But oh my gosh, it's a win. This is a success.
It's a good one, yeah.
This one's really good.